Hey guys, welcome back to Black Magic Craft. I am out in the woods, or temporary swamp really today, because I want to prove a point. One thing I see really often in the crafting communities, terrain building communities, YouTube comments, is the statement of do not spray paint styrofoam because it will melt. And I mean, that's simply not an entire truth. It's kind of true. Sometimes it's true, but it's not always true. New crafters are often told not to spray paint styrofoam because it will melt. And that actually is good advice, because if you're not really careful, it definitely will melt. And you know, it sucks to put a lot of time and effort into a project just to destroy it with some spray paint. But it's not the whole truth. You absolutely can spray paint foam, and you can do it safely, and you can do it with confidence. It just takes a little bit of knowledge and a little bit of practice. And I've done that many times on my channel with builds that I'm making for tutorial videos. So today I want to use a bunch of different spray paints here on foam to demonstrate how you shouldn't do it and how you should do it and how you can do it. It's really not rocket surgery. Like really, there's only a couple small things you need to keep in mind when approaching this. Inside a can of spray paint, there is not only paint. The reason you have to shake it is because you have to mix the paint up with the thinner or carrier inside this. There's also a propellant that helps it spray out. The paint inside these cans typically does not melt the foam. It's the other substances that do. So really, the only trick is getting the paint on the foam without those other substances getting on the foam. Some paints are going to be more aggressive than others. So the other factor when doing this safely is simply testing your paints on some raw foam, because all paint probably can be painted safely. Some are going to be easier than others. Really, you just got to spray from far enough away. So what I'm going to do is mix up all of these paints, which is going to take me some time here. And then I'm gonna spray one side the wrong way and one side the right way, and we're gonna take a look at the result. And while I sit here and shake six cans of spray paint forever, it's a good time to take a minute and discuss the sponsor of this video. If you're watching this channel, it's likely you're a creative person that enjoys learning new skills. And Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of classes for creative and curious people like yourself. They offer a huge variety of classes, including many focused on the arts that could easily be applied to our hobby, like painting and color theory. If you've been considering starting your own hobby YouTube channel but don't know where to start when it comes to things like filming, editing, using a camera, graphic design, or any of the other skill sets involved in creating content, well, this is just about the absolute best place you can go to learn about these things. Because their videos are curated specifically for education, you won't have any outside distractions like ads, so you may find it easier to focus on the classes. Personally, one of the skills I have yet to fully develop or understand is color grading and color correction on film. So I'm going to be using the Premiere Pro Lumetri Color Correct Like a Pro class by Jordy Vandeput to help me get my head around this a little bit better. Learning a new skill can be a great way to decompress and de-stress, and because the subscription to this service is only 10 bucks a month, it can be a really worthwhile investment for self-care as well as self-development. The first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link in the video description will get a 2-month free trial of premium membership so you can explore your own creativity. Oh God, I'm so tired. Okay, first I'm gonna paint the wrong way, which is spraying very, very close up. And this is the mistake that essentially everybody makes. They spray, it's really close, and all those solvents in this can are right there to melt the foam. You wanna spray from at least 12 inches away. Keep a nice distance and do light passes. The idea here is you're misting it with essentially almost dry paint. And it's crucial that you apply it in thin layers so that the foam is never really wet or oversaturated with paint. You just wanna dust it on a couple passes and hopefully you should have no melting. gonna let those dry. We'll take them inside and we will compare the results. So I think it's pretty safe to say that the results of this demonstration experiment are pretty obvious. All six of the brands that I used here performed pretty much exactly the same as I expected. Across the board, where I sprayed it too close and too heavy, we experienced melting of the foam, but where I sprayed it lightly, from a distance, I did not. Some are more extreme than others, and that's really where the difference between brands is going to show up. This gray here, this was the Premier Primer. Now, this is a brand that I believe is only available at Canadian Tire. Some people sometimes ask me what my preferred spray paint is for foam, and it is this. I don't think that question, I don't think the answer really matters, because as I'm showing you here, you can get the same safe results with many different brands, but this is one that I know to be very light in the melting department. Even when you make a mistake and spray it too closely, it dries really flat. So I personally prefer it, and I use it for gray, black, and white. Even the ones here that are a lot more aggressive in their melting, like that's a fair bit, are totally fine where I sprayed them properly. And this is raw foam. I mean, this is the difference between doing it right and doing it wrong. And this is just one coat. Of course, now I can go back in and do it again to get it more, you know, opaque and a more solid color using the same techniques. It's not gonna get worse. Actually, on the second pass, it's gonna be even safer. And this is raw foam again. If you coat your project first in Mod Podge for other reasons, for like durability and for, you know, gluing bits together, it's actually gonna improve these results further, both from being, you know, in the wrong application and the right application. Of course, it's really important to test it on raw foam. I want to make something crystal clear here. I am not advocating that you take the project you just poured a lot of effort and time and love into and grab some spray paint and just go nuts, because spray paint is totally safe on foam. I'm really not saying that. I'm saying that spray paint can be used effectively and safely on your foam if you put in the effort and follow best practices. At the end of the day, if you melt your project with spray paint, it's your own fault. You know, that whole spray paint doesn't melt foam, people do. It comes down to how you use the tool, or I guess the material in this case. I'm also not advocating that everyone really try to eagerly switch to using spray paint on foam. If you don't feel the need or the desire to do so, don't feel obligated. But if you're the kind of person that really wishes they could use foam, I want you to take some time to play around and practice and understand this technique, and know that if you want to, you can use it safely with a bit of effort. I suggest taking the spray paint you already have, or just buying a couple cans, taking some raw foam, and go out in the yard and spray paint it exactly like I did. Do it wrong and do it right. See how it behaves, see how it acts, see which brands are the easiest to get right, which ones have the least amount of chance of failure, and just practice. And then within some time, you will be confident spraying your own finished pieces. I hope you found this video helpful. I know it's not the most exciting or entertaining of the videos I make. I didn't make anything, but this has been something that's really been on the back of my head for quite some time. And I just really wanted to get it out there and have this be said and this resource available, because I do reference spray painting foam safely quite often in my video. So now you know what that actually means. And again, doesn't really mean much. It's pretty easy. It's just spray from the right distance. Okay. Follow the directions and you should be good. If you did like the video, hit the like button. Let me know in the comment section below. If you have any other tips for using spray paint on foam that you found useful, by all means, share them. I'm sure other people would be happy to hear them. If you want to pick up any tools or supplies for your own hobby needs, I don't think spray paint's going to be one of those things. But other things, you can head over to blackmagiccraft.ca. There I have my essential equipment page. I list all the stuff I use. I explain the things. a link to it. You can get it delivered to your home and help out the channel in the process. If you really want to help out the channel though, if you really like what I do and you get a lot of value out of it, and maybe if I've helped you save a lot of money or invigorated an exciting new hobby for you and your family, consider supporting the channel on Patreon. It's through Patreon that I get the resources that allow me to do these videos each and every week, and I'm very grateful for it. Thanks to all my patrons who have joined up recently, stuck around for many years, and really thanks to those of you who have been around for like almost 2 years now. That's crazy. Anyways, I'd love to have the rest of you as new members of the Black Magic Craft Fellowship. All right, spray paint. Don't be afraid. Cheers.